Hello friends, in my previous video, I have talked about 10 mistakes in retirement planning. In this video, I am going to talk about post-retirement mistakes. So in this video, you will get to know top 10 mistakes after retirement. And at the end, you can assess where do you stand. So let's start. To me, first one is spend more during initial years of retirement. It has been seen that people spend more after their retirement. They spend on vacation, they spend on party, they spend on many things. It is okay to spend, and it is obvious that you have waited for so long to enjoy retirement life, and then also if you restrict yourself, then it will give bad feeling. But you need to remember, if you have separate fund for spending on all these luxury, then only you should go, else restrict your spending. Second one is, do not change the lifestyle. If earning is there, if pension amount is big, then it is okay to not change the lifestyle. But if pension amount is limited, earnings are limited, in that case, if post-retirement people will not change their lifestyle, then again in near future it will become difficult to manage with the available fund, and it is not at all advisable to withdraw more and more amount from retirement fund. If there is a possibility to save some, save it for future years. Third one is, spend lump sum on child education, marriage, etc. Try to avoid spending on child education or marriage. If you know you need to bear for your child education or child marriage after your retirement, then you need to make plan before, not after retirement. And after retirement, it is again not advisable to spend your retirement fund on child education or marriage. Spending lump sum amount on these will make calculation wrong, and again in future it may cause some trouble. So before retirement itself, make a plan. Or ignore future expenditure on health need. One thing which is very, very important to note is that as days will pass, expenditure on health will increase, it will not decrease. And also we need to add impact of inflation on health need. So if certain amount is there which is going for health need now, it will increase. So don't make that mistake that it will remain the same amount, it will increase. So plan accordingly. Fifth, running short of cash but having more immovable property. Post retirement you should have cash. If you have many properties but you're running short of cash, then this is also problematic. I will tell you, it will be not easy to sell those property when there will be need of cash. Meaning, if there is no cash, then it will require to adjust. So when making retirement plan itself, try to make a plan in such a way that post retirement you will be having more and more cash instead of more and more immovable property. Sixth, do not update the retirement plan. It is not that post retirement you should not bother about retirement plan. It is ongoing process. So after retirement you need to update retirement plan. You need to see which investment is fetching good return, which one is not fetching good return. Is it okay to invest in new type of opportunities or what? So it is important to update retirement plan. Seventh, insecure investment in hope of more interest. In most of the cases it happens that after retirement everyone wants to have risk-free return on investment. There should not be any risk, so they tend to avoid investment in stock market where there is more risk. But what they do is they invest in other investment avenues where they get more interest. So you need to know any place where you are investing your money, and if you think that you cannot take risk, then you need to make sure that you are investing 100% in secure investment only. Though I disagree with the idea that post-retirement you need to invest 100% in risk-free investment only. It is okay to invest certain amount in mutual fund. 8th is forget tax planning name. Do not forget tax planning. So post-retirement you need to assess your yearly income, how much interest you are getting, whether you need to pay any income tax on interest or how it is happening. You need to see how much TDS is getting deducted and is it possible to get tax rebate on interest. 9th, not willing to take little bit of risk. As I told earlier that I disagree when people say they cannot take risk. It is okay to take risk. I'm not saying take big risk, but yes, take little bit of risk and invest some amount in mutual fund. If it is neck to neck, then there is no point. But yes, if there is a possibility that you are able to save some portion of your pension, then I would suggest start SIP and make little bit of contribution in mutual fund. But again, it depends on your risk taking capability, but you can try for some time. 10th, not updating self. Post retirement, if you update yourself, you will get to know that there are many different avenues available wherein you can invest your amount and you can get good return. Earlier it was not easy, but now information is available everywhere. Think about mutual fund. Now if you want to invest in mutual fund, within few minutes you will be able to do so. So keep updating, keep learning. You need to think that you have retired from your job. That's it. Not from learning or not from updating yourself or not from any other thing. So at the last, you need to remember that cash is more important than properties. So I hope you will try to avoid these 10 mistakes after retirement. Thank you for watching my video.